initially when I met Ada and I didn't like him, I hated him. But then we went for a lunch date and within a couple of weeks he was living with me.
Life was good. We were both happy in our jobs. We were happy together. We had a nice life.
I was someone who was a bit of an adrenaline junkie. I enjoyed my job. And then I had a stroke dramatically 2 years into our relationship. I was involved whilst I was on duty in a minor road traffic collision at work. I sustained minor whiplash in my neck and a clot formed and the clot dispersed into my brain, causing a stroke.
They brought me in to see her. It was lifeless with tubes hanging out of her. And I stood there on my own, not wondering, is that it?
Doctors decided I had locked-in syndrome. Effectively, I was a prisoner in my own body. Inside, I was screaming, but I just looked serene and peaceful as I lay there. Everybody had ignored me, I felt, all day, but Adrian, when he walked in, he looked directly at me, and he said, "Clodagh, are you there? Blink once for yes." And as he looked at me, I thought, he knows I'm there, but it was the slowest blink of my life because I was like, I can't mess this up. And he looked at me and he laughed and he said, "You're going to be all right."
It really gave me a lot of hope and there was a lot of joy. I just knew that Clodagh was still, she was still there. When she was in the rehabilitation unit, they used to ask for goals. And at the first family meeting, Clodagh spelled out through a spell board, "I will walk out of here." And the consultant basically said, "That's a nice thing to think about, but let's be realistic, that's not happening."
I think it was a very difficult patient because I wouldn't accept that it's permanent. And I remember spelling out with my spell board, "You're full of bullshit. This is bullshit. I will walk out. I will talk again."
Knowing Clodagh, I didn't doubt it. After 6 months, she was able to walk out of the doors of the hospital. And that was huge. It was huge. Every little thing that she has developed, she'll work on it to improve it. The one thing Clodagh has is her determination and drive to overcome things.
Recovery is like a recipe where you need all the ingredients. And the Stroke Association has been one of the really important ingredients. And it enabled me through their Life After Stroke grant to get a cross trainer. And that cross trainer has been invaluable in my recovery.
For me, I had a lot of people asking me about Clodagh and how she's getting on, and it was really nice to turn around to people and say, "Hey, she's coming back to work next week," and that blew people away.
Returning to work has been difficult. It's perhaps the first time that you fully realise, yes, I have disabilities and I have a lot further to go.
She has such a strong, determined spirit. She adapts and overcomes, and to me it's just unbelievable what she's achieved through that.
I think my dreams are no different than they were pre-stroke. I want to do well at work and I'd like to study and become a detective. The first time that Adrian and I went out in the trike together and Adrian just screamed really euphorically, "We've got our life back," and that felt wonderful.
I've never met anybody with more determination and courage than Clodagh. She does inspire me every day.